Don't it just flow in an endless loop? It goes up to the clouds, falls down in the rain, floats through lakes, rivers, oceans, then goes up again.
Jake and I took a canoe trip on the Peace River with outdoor educator Mr. Kayton Nedza. We wanted to learn about the river habitat and also help clean up some of the trash.
Here we are on the Peace River at Nocatee. Nocatee's in DeSoto County, and it's about a third of the way up the watershed from Charlotte Harbor.
Soon we were speeding along. I think Jake's got the paddling down.
It's amazing how much easier it is to paddle when the motor's going.
Why is the river so brown colored?
Well, the river is brown colored because of the tannic acid that's in it. Tannic acid is a chemical that comes out of the roots and the leaves of trees, and it has this brown color.
Look, a tire.
There's a tire over here. That's one type of pollution that we find in the Peace River.
Time to get out and begin the cleanup. We soon had that old tire in the canoe. Every little bit hurts.
What is the craziest thing you found in this river?
The craziest thing I found in the river? Well, there was the toilet.
You found a toilet in the river?
Yeah, we found a toilet in the river. We found a bedpan in the river. But I guess the craziest thing we found in the river was a car.
You found a whole car?
A whole car.
It was so beautiful out there on the water. Hard to imagine why anyone would want to dump stuff in it. But when we paddled into the shore, it didn't take us long to find more trash.
We're not only polluting it for people, but we're also polluting it for other life forms.
Yeah,
for example,
animals.
Yeah, animals, birds, fish, alligators even.
Is that why it's important to keep all the water in the watershed clean?
Yes, exactly, Jake. Anytime a can is dropped anywhere, whether it's in parts of Fort Myers or whether it's all the way up at Winter Haven, it could wash down a ditch and into a creek and into the river and eventually down into Charlotte Harbor itself.
We dragged some nets along the bottom to see what else we would find.
I got lots of styrofoam and some mud.
Uh-oh. Styrofoam?
Yeah.
Oh, and that's all broken up too, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, it could be
gross.
Anywhere.
Was there nothing but trash in the river? Wait a minute. What's
this? I dare you to touch it. What is that?
That is an insect larva called a Dobson fly. It would turn into a Dobson fly. It's called a helgamite in the larva stage.
Did you catch that? A Dobson fly in its larval stage is called a helgamite and lives in the river for a couple of years before turning into an adult fly, which can grow to be 3 to 4 inches long and only lives for about 7 days.
Why is the river important to him?
Well, because his mother came and laid eggs in the river many months ago, and now he's hatched out and he's living on the river bottom, and then he climbs out of the river and turns into an adult, has wings, and flies away. Without clean water in the river, then he would not exist.
But wait a minute. I thought insects only had 6 legs. This little guy's got way more than 6.
Oh, but look, he does have 6. He's got his front legs, he's got his middle legs, he's got his back legs, and all of these things are not real legs.
Oh. Yeah.
They're called fake legs. They're called pseudopods.
Oh.
And when he turns into a full adult insect, all he's going to have left is the 6 legs that insects have, and all of these will disappear, and that will just become the abdomen of
the
insect.
Does he have eyes?
Yeah, he has eyes. He's looking at you. He said, oh, look at that big monster in the orange life jacket.
Let's make sure we put him back to keep him safe.
Okay, are we ready to turn him loose?
Yeah.
Off he went. One little insect grateful for a clean river. He may be small, but he plays an important role in the web of life. Jake and I had fun on the river that day, and we were glad we could help clean it up a little.